Well, what is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to A Therapeutic Edge. Thank you so much for joining me. Hey, I have got something from the mind of Casey over at KnivesFAST on the table. This is the Microburst, and this is a great knife. I said on my live that one of the things that happens on review channels, I've heard about this sort of complaint, is that everything's the greatest thing ever. Well, okay, look. The Microburst is not fancy. It's not anything particularly new, right? You've seen blade shapes like this. You've seen handle shapes like this. However, what Casey did was put them together in just really nice proportions. So he made something great out of things that aren't that uncommon. This is a prototype. The actual production model will... So the protos are in D2, for instance, but production is going to be in 14C, which is really cool. You get two options. One is black micarta with stone wash and shiny silver hardware, whereas this one is black micarta and black wash with black hardware. I like this one. I usually like plain blade, but this is really nice. I've had this for about a week, and it is just an excellent cutting tool. And in the end, that's what we really want. Oh, by the way, these are going to be about $88 and, what do you say, $88.70? Something very specific like that. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, $88.90. Excuse me. That's very specific, Casey. It's got his Tempest Knives pivot on there. It has the Tempest Knives logo there. This one says D2, but that's because that's the prototype. These will be 14C, as I said. It's this shape that makes this such an excellent knife to use. The thumb studs are out of the cutting path, right? And you put your finger down here to guide that cut so you don't worry about slipping into this choil. And it just shreds whatever you're working on. It really does cut well. And part of that is because it's this super high grind. It's got a lovely swedge right here. It's got nice jimping where your thumb lands, although my big hands come forward a little more than that. This thing is great for draw cuts. Look at that. Just whoosh. It's got enough tip on it to be a little pokey if you needed it to be, but mostly what this is an EDC cutting tool, and for that it's marvelous. You can get quite a bit of the blade down on the table before the handle hits, but most importantly, because of this big belly up here at the front, you can chop nicely. So back up in the kitchen, camping kitchen, whatever, it would work really well for that. It does have a wire clip. These are the same as the, it's the Spyderco pattern, so you can do aftermarket clips on this thing fairly easily. The micarta is done very well. This is really nice, Casey. Action is just fantastic, right? Just snappy, right? Drops closed, just, yeah. That's really well done. Got a nice backspacer with a lanyard spot and the tail end of the knife out of the way of everything important, which is, if I'm going to have one, that's the way I like it because I don't put lanyards on my knives. Yep. Casey did a good thing here. Let's get some size, some specs out of the way, shall we? You get 2.5 inches of cutting on 3 inches of 14C28N, the reduction version. I'm here going to hear some people complain, oh, you could have got another quarter inch out of it if you hadn't put that choil. Because of the way he did this, this knife works beautifully for women carry knives and for me. You're going to get no arguments from me. And it turns out this is more than enough blade for about 90% of the thing, 100% of the things I do on my actual daily carry, which is just packages and tape and stuff. So anyway, 2.5 inches of cutting on 3 inches of 14C. The grip area, we're gonna do it twice. So from behind the forward choil is 1, 2, 3, 4 full inches to this line. So you're looking at about 3 inches from back here. You know, I can hold, because, I mean, my pinky rolls off the back, because of the way the shape, it actually feels fairly comfortable and well sorted this way. But coming forward, yeah, buddy. Knife overall, we're coming in at 7 inches, which is a nice, smaller knife, but because of this extra handle, doesn't feel small in hand. Closed length, 4 inches, I mean 4 inches and a little tiny bit, 4 inches and a 16th, maybe, so 4 inches. Closed profile's pretty good. You got a nice tall blade, so it's going to eat up a little bit of pocket, but we're still coming in an inch and a half this way. And of course, because it's, excuse me, thumb stud deployed, there's nothing to bang on anything in the pocket. And because this is Micarta, I'd put my phone next to this. I would. There's nothing on this knife that's going to like scratch screens or mar stuff in your pocket. It's really nice. Let's do some size comparisons. What do we have? What do we have that's different? Here it is against the Rat 2. These knives are very similar in size. You get actually about the same amount of cutting, a little more cutting on the Rat 2. But this, I can't stand this knife. I like the Rat 1, but the Rat 2, there's no comfortable way for me to hold this knife. It's just too bumpy, and I don't enjoy this knife at all. we have a Rat 1 here. Speaking of the rats, there you go. As you can see, it's considerably smaller than a Rat 1. Let's go back to the Spydercos. Here it's the Para 3. These knives are similar in size. Similar design ideals too, right? The Para 3's got a really short blade, but you come forward onto this choil and it's really good that way. This is much the same design idea. You just come forward onto the blade and all the cutting that you need to do is right where you want it to be. Yep, that's a very, very similar bit of cutting reality right there. Here it is against the PM2. Of course, PM2 is just going to dwarf the Microburst. I mean, it's called the Microburst. It's a smaller knife. And for those of you with fancier tastes, here it is against a Sebenza 31. Okay, I just wanted to play with that knife again. Anyway, the Microburst is, let's see, I've got some dates. Pre-order will be January 21st, which is next weekend. Delivery hoped in early April. So, late March, early April. Okay. So January, February, March. We're getting 3, maybe 4 months after the pre-order. That's just manufacturing time. That's to be expected. Don't sleep on this. For basically $89, you are supporting an excellent member of the community. And if you haven't followed the Knives Fast channel, you should. I'll put a link in the description. You're supporting an excellent member of the community. You're supporting a guy with great knife aesthetic and design. I really like the things he has done. And you're getting a really cool knife for less than $100, which is, I'm good with that all day. Anyway, that's where we're going to leave it. This has been the Microburst. This is the prototype, but the real ones are coming in March, April. Follow along on the Tempest Knives website if you're interested. Please go follow Casey over at Knives Fast. He has more subscribers than I do, but he can always use a few more. In fact, if you're one of Casey's fans, come over and subscribe to my channel. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. This is a great little knife. Casey, I think you've done something really cool here, and I very much appreciate it and the opportunity to look at it. Hope you guys are having a great day. We'll see you next time.